Sector 1 of B738, over.
the
B-9737.
Okay, I got no point here for you. Okay, the pilot one ready. Report to the plane, over.
Actually, I made some inquiries about this, and he made some calls, so I don't know how much that helped or if Dale Woodland was involved, because I'm acquainted with the archivist out at the Railroad Museum in Strasbourg, and he made some calls, so I don't know.
Because I contacted them a while ago. They never got it back to me.
No?
Yeah, I didn't know whether or not.
Did you talk to anybody live?
No, I emailed, but
Kurt Bell, the archivist, he's from Chalfine. That's how I knew him. From the area originally.
Yeah, I emailed them a while ago to see if they were interested.
Yeah.
And actually, I think I talked to Dale a while ago, and I've talked to people from Reading, from the NRHS.
NRHS, yeah.
But we have no place to put it. Actually asked me if I wanted it in my backyard. My neighbors be pissed.
Yeah. Well, if it goes to Hamburg with the Reading Company Hector site, that'd probably be the best place.
Well, they have to have a place to put it, though. That's the thing.
Well, they got all that facility in Hamburg now, right?
Well, it's got to make sense, though, where they put it. That's the thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, Railroad Plaza would be nice right over here.
Yeah.
I don't know what they do.
Aesthetically, it may not quite fit in with what they got in mind, right?
Or they have a walking trail down here. They're going to, when they put in the retirement community in here.
Oh, yeah.
South of Stony Creek, they're going to have a walking trail. It'll be perfect right there in the corner. Except that this wants it out of the way.
Right. It doesn't fit in with the plan. Well, at least the brother's willing to stow it.
Actually, I even contacted Lansdale Bethlehem Society, and they
do nothing.
They said as long as it doesn't show up on our doorstep in the morning.
Yeah. Yeah,
excuse me.
Say what?
You're at the Staggering Addison Bar right now.
Oh, aren't you the hero though?
How's that?
You found the board.
I didn't find nothing.
You didn't find nothing?
No. It's been in there all along.
Oh, okay. Good.
No, it doesn't pay to be a hero. Heroes get fired.
Oh, really? So I still can't figure out what the hell they're going to do with it. Probably going to just set up a nice green get.
They want it unbolted. Every bolt intact.
Really?
And the only thing we can cut is the base. We have to, because we can't pull it out of the ground.
It's a foundation. How deep does that suck?
We're going to take it to 9th Street and everything we can attach it
to. Stairway included?
Yes.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. That's where they bought the iron rules. Cool. They get unbolt everything in one piece.
Very cool.
Are they numbering the bolts? You know what they do? When they disassemble older houses, they number each board.
Yeah, really?
Oh, yeah. And bricks.
But guess what? Whoever puts this one together better have had a Lego set when he was a kid, all right?
It's pretty cut and dry. Can't get much simpler.
Well, they wanted to sling it, even still. They wanted to sling it so it wouldn't collapse the roof. So they have to put the extensions out.
Oh, yeah, there's not much to it.
What is it?
It's done.
You can put your fist through it.
It's done in Reading pre-bankruptcy sheet.
Yes.
It's
a crack house in the air is what it is.
Basically, it didn't get cold enough to kill the operator. It gave him just enough shelter.
Had they replaced it?
That's
original.
Yeah.
It's original.
Well, no, they've replaced. That's like the sixth box. It's been there.
Is
six. The sixth kind of, structure that's been there.
What was the original?
Originally, it was like probably close to that outhouse you had there. Mm-hmm. A wooden shack with a guy with a flag.
Well, Louis said one time they had pump gates. Well,
I'm sure, yeah.
They
had lots of things. I mean, in the beginning, we're talking about 1850s. They just had a guy or a woman they might not even had a shack. They might have had it from the hotel. Oh, yeah. Train's coming. I got to go out and flag the crossing. And then they gradually, as they got more and more sophisticated, they you ever see that? You saw those pictures on the internet. What is it? The 9th Street crossing the Trenton? The Pensy-Trenton Street is crossing the 9th Street branch, or the Port Richmond branch. And you got four tracks for the Reading and three tracks for the Pensy.
Crossing.
Four diamonds for each one of them. And then they have, this thing that looks like a kind of a Dutch pyramid, which was the house for whoever's in charge of all that, all those damn switches and all those controls. And it was like the stuff they used to do back then. This is like 1890s. Actually, if you go on the site, there's a picture on there of it. And then they showed it when the Pensy elevated the Trenton and went over top. But back in 1890s, man, basically everything ran, right on top of each other.
Surprised you guys are the only ones out here.
No.
Surprised you guys are the only ones out here.
We're crazy. I'm crazy.
You were saying it's probably going to be Kook City. We thought people were going to tie themselves to it. Say, take me.
It's funny. You've been to the PLA down on South Street? I'd never been there before. I went to see Blue Review last year there.
Yeah.
And before that, someone said they were going to tear down the TLA. Oh my God, what a terrible thing it would be. Well, I went there. I said, man, I'd kiss the butt. That's a dump. That's like this. It's like, if that were from the 1920s or 30s, even 40s, it would be interesting. Well, in the 60s, it's the inside.
The last watchbox in America,
right? That's all over the place. It's either the last watchbox, but then these guys, friends of mine out in Chicago, they said there's one out there near Blue Island.
Sure.
And they still have a watchbox there.
It's just significant for where it is, not because it's...
What is one of the last?
Attractive or this?
Yeah, because...
Oh, there you go. Have to cut it.
One.
That's all right.